Silent Hill Homecoming, aka Silent Hill 6. Ah! On one hand, holy shit, we've been doing this for so long that we're on the sixth game when I just play one every October. On the other hand, like, pretty effective way to get through a series, just like the it's a marathon, not a sprint sort of situation, because, like, I don't think I've gotten through any series this consistently besides just playing the Souls games as they come out, and similarly playing one or two Yakuza games every year. Like, I tried to do something like this with other franchises a long time ago and never made this kind of distance, I guess. But anyway, we are firmly past the ones that people usually consider to be good, but who knows? That maybe there'll be surprises. In some ways, 3 is already borderline for a lot of people, and 4 is especially borderline. Interestingly, 5 was Silent Hill Origins, a Silent Hill I had never heard of a single time, but it wasn't like a mobile game. It wasn't even like a spin-off. It was just a Silent Hill game that was on consoles. That was just a Silent Hill game. Like, more true to the roots of the series, at least gameplay-wise, than, like, some of the other games that people talk about more. And I'm like, I don't know why everyone mysteriously never talks. Like, there's 3 post-Silent, Team Silent ones that people always talk about, and that's the ones we're at now. And we're starting them now, but, like, I'm just so confused why no one talks about Silent Hill Origins, which, among other things, I would just like to argue, it's just, like, it's actually a pretty good game. Like, it's just actually pretty decent. Maybe that's controversial or something. I've also heard that one of these 3 games we're going to be getting to this year, next year, and the next year after that is actually pretty good compared to the other 2. But I don't remember which one, so I'm just going to go into each of them hoping it's that one and just hope for the best. But anyway, oh my god, the Xbox 360 interface, sure, I guess. Still has my avatar that is a Xbox 360 webcam photo of the cover of Rock Band 3. I'm startled whenever I see that interface because it's been so long, but we're getting surprisingly modern now. We're getting to the part of Silent Hill franchise where I can just, like, buy the game and download it like a normal video game and just play it. Whereas up until now, they've been, like, games you have to, like, track down copies of because they're long-lost relics. They shouldn't be. 2 and 3 was supposed to have a remake, but that remake was somehow so much worse than the original product that that wasn't really an option. But here we are. Playing a 360 game now. I'm playing it on 360 because the Steam reviews look bad. Seems like it's back when PC games were much more questionable. Ports, I mean.
Where's my squad? Are they here? Did they make it? Hey! Hey, talk to me! Say something! Oh, God! Oh, God! Hey! Hey, what are they doing? What's going on there? Hey, where are you taking me? No! Hey! No! Where am I? Hey, what is this place? Hey, where are you taking me? No! Where am I, man? Hey, wait. Where are you going? Don't leave me here!
I like how he's, like, pre-equipped for a Silent Hill game. He's got a flashlight on his chest, and he's got a walkie-talkie, like, very obviously in the cutscene. Oh, he's not doing good. Oh! Okay, I should probably get out of here. Was that Pyramid Head? That was a very big Pyramid Head-style weapon, or Clock Tower, scissors, or something. My understanding of the logic of Silent Hill is that Pyramid Head should not be in any other thing. Let's see. Is this a real time? No, I think this does pause the game. Okay. I was gonna say, like, if it's real time, then it's like suddenly you have to worry about things. I thought look inversion was turned on. Off? No. 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 Okay, I'll just try not to look up and down very much. Why would you have a look inversion? Why would you have an aim inversion setting, but not a look inversion setting? And it defaulted to having the aiming inversion on? But there's no look inversion. But it defaults. Oh, okay. Get used to. Oh, man. Okay. 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 So I just get used to some various. Get used to a lot of camera bobs where it goes one way, then the other way as I try to fix that. A doctor's memo. When did this game come out? Too late for this to be a problem, right? Isn't it like 2007? The patient in room 206 is scheduled to undergo a transorbital lobotomy tomorrow. I've mandated the following medications be doubled on the day of the procedure. I thought lobotomies were obsolete. Who scheduled this procedure? I think that's him editorializing. So the first thought I had when I saw that intro cutscene was, oh, famously, Silent Hill is inspired by Jacob's Ladder, and these guys' solution for that was to put a Jacob's Ladder scene in the game. Like, that was just... I'm pretty sure that scene just basically happens in Jacob's Ladder. Like, being wheeled away in a gurney and seeing into various hospital rooms as questionable things are happening, in akin to, like, The Shining. I haven't seen Jacob's Ladder for a while. Looks like the lock is broken. I can't open it. Okay. That radio's already on. So we're at this point, we're just fully committed to having a third-person camera. Like a traditional third-person camera instead of anything even akin to the fixed camera angles of the previous games. I think 5 still had a... I don't remember. Actually, yeah, Silent Hill's always had a weirder relationship with fixed camera angles. It's been a little... Yeah, no. They sometimes use them, and sometimes it's kind of following you, and you've always kind of had some control over it.
Josh. Josh, is that you?
Alex. I guess I'm just somewhat remarking on how, like, it stands out that this is different because this is, like, very much an Xbox 360 over-the-shoulder kind of, like, camera angle. Mixing patient bulletin. Room 205. Patient went missing. Last seen in the day room after a confrontation with another. The rest of the message is blurred and illegible. Not according to the picture I can see. Hey, child. What are you up to? The gate is locked. Oops. Alright, so I need a password. There we go. Got the map. Josh. A little funny to put a person on your map like they're just gonna stand still for you. We have a dedicated map button. I guess we did before it was select, but now it's D, now it's Y. I don't know why it's a D. Attention staff, our security has been somewhat compromised. A patient used an x-ray film to write down the code for the security gate. We have recovered the first half, but the second half is still missing. Should you find the missing x-ray piece, be sure to notify the head of security immediately. Okay. X24. something else. Gotta find the other half. They recovered it, but then they just kept it around. Yep. You right, buddy? You okay? Yeah? Oh. Is there a run button? I'm just having a moment of, like, awareness. Whoa! Action boy Silent Hill man! What is this, Resident Evil 6? Alright. The John Woo of Silent Hill games. Nope. You didn't need to render physics on all these things, it's okay. It's really goofy to have stuff like that getting knocked around. It is worth noting... Okay, creepy baby's happening. It's worth noting that... when I go through a door, it's just a real door, it's not a video game door. It's not like a loading transition door. So, like, I'm not teleporting to a different reality the way you do in most Silent Hill and Resident Evil games, which means I'm not safe, potentially. A page from an incident report. A patient proceeded to leap through the window and then ravaged the adjacent room. The patient was not responsive to verbal commands. Three staff members eventually subdued the patient. The patient entered a catatonic state and stopped responding to outside stimuli. Restraints were unnecessary during the following week's electroshock therapy sessions. So this is a not good times asylum where they do all the things you're not supposed to do. And that's a baby! I thought I was hearing it from the other room. It's a doll though, right? Yeah. A child's doll. It appears to be burned. I wonder how it got here. I guess we'll never know, unless you played the previous games. So that was bad. Here we go. I bet something bad happens when I do this, like in every Outlast game. As always, go into the creepy dark place, get the item. Oh, nothing happens on the way there, huh? Yeah, but now you gotta go back with the item. Suddenly some bad stuff's gonna happen. Basic weapon combat. Today's soldier needs to be prepared for the rigors of training and beyond. These are techniques that are going to keep you alive in the field. To equip a weapon, hold down or tap right bumper and use left stick to select your weapon of choice. To get in your combat stance, pull and hold left trigger with the weapon, melee weapon equipped. When you enter combat stance and enemies are present, you'll automatically target the closest enemy in your field of view. If multiple enemies are surrounding you, the target will be the closest hostile. The target enemy will be highlighted by the flashlight. Change targets with right stick. To break targeting any time, stop locking on. Fast attacks, strong attacks, charge attacks, and combos. When in combat stance, press A for fast attacks or X for strong attacks. Strong attacks can be charged up for added damage by holding down X. Success of fast attacks followed by a strong attack and make- Oh, so you do combos? It has a combo system like Dynasty Warriors. Alright. Is weapon durability back? I consistently wish for these games to behave a little bit more like survival horror games. Where it's often a good idea to conserve resources by avoiding fights. But, ooh, what are you looking at? Were you just looking at are you looking at the thing I already read? But, when I approached the first Silent Hill game that way, people complain about it to this day because you really are just supposed to gun everything down and you have more than enough ammo to do so, and I'm like, oh, that's... I imagined a cooler game in my head a little bit. There's definitely an irony to the idea that most Silent Hill protagonists are more capable, despite the narrative context, than most Resident Evil protagonists are. Until they all become insane action games. Hey buddy, you're that was an attempt at a jump scare. It's just I'm too ready for it, and you're... you look like you're made of rubber. He was like stretching and he's clipping through the boards. Oh, this game might be jank as fuck. Alright, let's go. Let's go. Bad horror games are almost as good as good horror games. Ooh, I think I double tapped and it caused me to slam into it. So 624. Do I scroll there? Okay. Are you gonna put it? Okay. 624872. I spelled boobs. Alright.
Josh, where are you going?
Josh! Stop joshing me! That was the quietest door slam I've ever heard. Is that just the real game, or is there an emulation problem? Because I'm playing an Xbox 360 game on an Xbox One? Hexagons! Or is it because he's a ghost? He's not really here, so he doesn't actually make sounds when he slams doors, even though he'd make sounds with his mouth. I got child's drawing. Three little piggies. Oh, that doesn't end well for the piggies. It looks like the lock is broken. I don't know why I need to stop reading these. Also, when I end up trying the door twice, it's usually because I'm trying to press A to clear the text, because I think that's usually how these games worked. But, instead, it just tries again, because you're not actually locked into the text.
Josh! Stop!
Well, that time I made a sound. Nice! Bud. He's dead. It's hard to tell what happened to him. But I don't want to stick around to find out. Yeah, everyone's pretty dead around here. This was an extremely populated nightmare hospital until the exact moment we got up. Although I guess the thing that killed the guy that brought us here is implied to have killed everyone else. Not that there's continuity necessarily in Silent Hill games moment to moment. Oh, I don't like this coming up every time. Why does it have to be cloud saves? Why can't you just save locally? That's weird, right? Well, it saved successfully, so I'm just gonna hope it works out. Hope my internet doesn't go out or something. Overall, not the worst visuals for a 360 game, I guess. I'm not sure. I'm trying to imagine a comparison, I guess. Like, I don't know, Condemned was neat. This looks a little bit like... Condemned might have looked better. Condemned was probably scarier. Condemned actually got pretty scary at some point. Why is it locked? Is someone in there? Hello? Oh! The entire city just starts freaking out like Pee-wee's Playhouse. He said the word! It's combat knife! Ah! Oh, here we go. Get him! Did it. Ba-doop. We did it. Oh, hello. That's neat. Well, maybe things will get cooler now. Sorry, maybe I'm being a little too flippant and rude, just by some people's standards. I don't know what it is about this era of gaming. It is so much harder for me to take a horror game seriously from this era. Like, something about the presentation of the tutorial and the exploration and the cutscenes, everything about it is instantly like, oh, this game's bad, isn't it? Maybe it's because it resembles it so immediately reminds me of the Alone in the Dark game that we played that was very, 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 very bad from basically this year-ish. It might be that. That might have poisoned it for me a bit. And it might be because maybe it just is kind of iffy. I don't know. They straight up are like, here's a scene from Jacob's Ladder. Here's maybe Pyramid Head. Pick up a weapon. Oh, look, a nurse. Remember nurses from Silent Hill? And like, oh, it's the transition. It's the transition into the darkness of Silent Hill. But like, I definitely already feel like something is missing because there's not like, I feel like there's a lack of buildup to this happening. Like, it's like, oh, just very like abruptly. It's like, here are times. Welcome to the Rust dimension. You like the transition where all the rust, all the paint flies away and stuff? It's Rust mode. I'm like, I've been playing for like 5 minutes. Something feels wrong about how immediately I have this. And then my character doesn't even barely gives a shit. And then I just beat the shit out of a nurse with a knife. He's just really, he's immediately ready to stab the fuck out of a completely human looking woman. Cause she was kind of creepy, but she didn't even actually make a move at me. Admittedly, I'd be kind of jumpy at this point if the world did this, but like, he doesn't know I know what a Silent Hill nurse is. He doesn't know what a Silent Hill nurse is. So I'm like, that's a weirdly strong reaction. Are you a serial killer? Everyone that goes into Silent Hill, except for the guy in Origins, who just seems to be a stand-up dude, I guess. We stan. all the people in Silent Hill have like a dark past they're running from. Are you a serial killer that preys on women? Because that was a weird reaction if you weren't. You just kept stabbing. I know that I'm controlling him. I'm not insane. I'm just like pointing out like he really was ready for that. Like, you can interpret it to some extent as being like, up until the point where the cutscene gives me control, he could have had some kind of reaction or hesitation or something. But they're like, it's time for the combat tutorial in our video game. In a specific form of gaminess that somewhat doesn't feel true to the series directly. And I'm the guy that defended 4 and 5 to varying degrees. I like 5 more than 4. This is interesting because it kind of incentivizes. I mean, I guess I always try every door anyway, but like, it's a very different feel once you Okay, actually got me a little bit with that. It's dark enough that I couldn't tell what it is. Alright, yep. The atmosphere is better the moment it's the Rust dimension. The doctors say that I'm unable to discern fantasy from reality. Is that chair real? We'll never know. But I think I know what's going on around here. I saw those demons murder the other patients. I want to escape from this cursed place, but I don't dare venture into the light. It seems they're attracted to the light. That's why people who need light to see are their natural prey. They also react strongly to sound. If you want to go on living, you'd be better off just sitting in the dark and staying quiet. But even that probably won't save you. Cool. You know what will probably save me is this knife. Can I not try this door? Because there's a note on it? Shit. What am I, a Japanese demon or something? Am I being prevented from opening doors because there's a paper charm on it? Like, what? Like, I put a note up so I can't try the door. There's an intense heat coming from this vent. That's the sound that means something's coming. Is it in here? Oh, there she is. It's interesting that he can tell the difference between a locked door and a broken lock. That's like a series-wide thing, I think, but it's just a little, huh.
Oh! There's another one! Hello.
Oh, that's a hell of a lock-on, the entire camera goes in on it.
Ow! Shit!
You put up a more of a fight.
They're like, oh, well, they're attracted to light, so we should. Oh, shit. A radio on still, I think, maybe. Well, she's coming anyway. Unless I can. Ah, shit. Can I lose her now? I don't think I can lose her now. I think she sees me. Her movements are fun. Get her go. Wait, did I lose her? Shut up, TV. Oop. Wait, I did lose her. Huh. Okay. Yeah. Oh, I love, ooh, teeth? Well, the problem with turning my light off, though, is I have a Let's Play audience that will not be able to see, so, it leads to some struggles with there being a light mechanic to play with. Just infer what's happening on the screen, guys, I believe in you. Literally unwatchable. I can't believe he did that. Go through vents. It's always an intense heat. It's just, I can't actually see anything either in this case. Oh. Bugs! Do they have little faces? I can't tell. Oh, they have butts! Oh, wait, what? That thing bites straight through your clothes? That's impressive. Ah! Wait, I probably can't go through doors. Oh, that doesn't solve it! No! Get off my face! Oh boy, okay. Eh. Get off me. I was gonna say, my go-to response to that kind of situation is definitely to open a door, and that doesn't really work, does it? Because they just are with you. The door doesn't even close behind you, like, they just chase you. You're like, oh fuck! That's a new problem. Joshua's Robbie the Rabbit doll stuffed in his backpack. Wasn't the rabbit from like Silent Hill 4? Like one of the apartments? I know it's referenced in the really bad Silent Hill Revelations movie. I say really bad to specify that like actually the first movie is surprisingly decent in a lot of ways. I really wish we could have gotten the version they made first, because apparently they went back and made the movie much worse afterwards. Hello? That's probably I'm sure that's a make a drink. Me talking about the movies is probably like a take a drink moment. You just put that on your drinking game and or bingo card for these playthroughs, I'm sure. Hello. I was talking with somebody about the fact that like apparently like, the really shitty monologue that just stops the movie dead in its tracks was added afterwards. But also, every scene with Sean Bean was added afterwards. None of them were in the movie originally. It just seems a bit of an oversight. It's not an oversight, it's that people didn't like the first version of the movie, so they added a bunch of really tedious shit that made the movie much worse. Because every test audience is bad. Oh, it's dark in here. Are they coming for me? I think they're coming for me. I don't think this worked at all. My god, what are they doing here?
Can't get me. Oh shit, this isn't gonna work at all. This is not a door. Uh oh. I hear scraping noise. Hey. Yeah, Chow's drawing. Hooray. Oh, is that steam? Oh, I thought it was a metal scraping noise. I thought something was gonna come. It's the other half of the body from downstairs. I wonder who put it here. Holding onto a key of some sort. There's the key for downstairs. Wherever that door is. Does it show the door? I guess the other side? Gotta be a door somewhere in the operating theater. Hi. Friendly? Are you friendly? I don't think she's friendly. I got her. I got him. Alright, we're good. There it is. Can't get through here. The door is chained shut. Yeah, I know. I'm gonna die. Alright. Wait, how do I use the key? Where is it? Ow. Stop it. I know the door's chained shut. Alright, well, let's fight them. Oh, there's three! It's more than I thought there was. You can't get me? Oh, shit. I tried to combat roll, but you can't do it while you're locked on. Woohoo! K.O. Did she move with me? She looked like she moved with me. Dark Souls roll. It works. Oh. Where is she? Where is she? Done? Okay, so why couldn't I? Whip. Oh, left bumper. Right bumper is weapons, left bumper is other items. That's what I was messing up here. So I could have done it. Damn it. That's a decently strong heal. Right, we have an explicit health bar that shows up outside of pause menus. That's unusual. Normally you have a vague health bar that's like your heartbeat monitor or whatever, right? And you can only look at it by pausing the game. Which leads to an uncertainty during gameplay of how close you are to death. Setting the electroshock machine beyond the seizure threshold has yielded impressive results in the patients. The most violent and depressed patients are rendered completely docile. The only side effects have been minor. Memory loss, some dislocated bones, one fractured leg, and a patient bit off his tongue. This accident was quite a nice side effect, as this particular patient was also one of our noisiest. Well, fuck you. I've instructed the doctors to continue with this intensity level for all treatments. Okay, so they're pretty fucked up. I keep knocking stuff over? It's one thing to have things like jangle around you, because that, like, something just jangling but not falling over is the opportunity to be like, oh fuck! Like, if you're trying to sneak or something, then like something jangling would be a moment where you think like, oh shit, they're gonna hear me. But stuff comically ragdolling around on the floor and having full physics is a strange choice for a Silent Hill game. Not a thing that really came up until now. It's just kind of a generally goofy thing that you kind of forgive or even enjoy in a shooter or whatever. but in a very serious, grim, Rust Dimension nightmare hell thing. It's just kind of like, oh, yeah, you're right, this is the Xbox 360. We were very proud of our physics engines right about now. Maybe too proud.
Joshua, is that you?
I'm busy. Go away.
What are you doing here?
I want my toy.
Oh, dialogue options.
Aren't you afraid of being here alone?
I'm a brave soldier. I'm looking for Robbie.
Is there anything I can do?
Find Robbie. I want my toy.
I haven't seen any toys around here.
Guess you're not my friend.
Okay, I'll go see if I can find him.
Okay. He wants his toy. And we're just like acting like this is a normal request, given how intense things are. But that's pretty normal for Silent Hill. People have to have just incorrect responses to stimuli. Am I going back? Oh, the nurse center probably opens. There we go. Ironically, no nurses here. Is that a note? Nope. Not for me. I was gonna say that dialogue choices seem like something that might, like, change the endings. But it's a fool's errand to guess how the endings work in these games. The logic of how the good or bad endings work from game to game changes dramatically every time. There's no consistent rule. Up to including, I think, 3 just straight up being like, you always get this ending the first time, and you always get this ending the second time. You just have to play the game again for another ending. Like, 4's ending was based on an entire mechanic that has never existed before. In 1, I think you had to essentially go find the ending in an optional area that I never found. It was like a whole ass level I just completely missed somehow. Because, well, they do... You'd have to find it during the part where you're running around. Where you're running around the Rust Dimension in like a... What's like even a little bit of a small open world kind of feeling area. Oh, hey, Robbie. He's gonna get sucked in, isn't he? Yep. Oh, it's a flesh hole. That's not what windows are. That's icky. That's genuinely unnerving. I do not like this hole. Why is it flesh? It's supposed to be glass. Oh, don't do that. Do it. Oh, that was a horrible idea. Yup. Whew. If I fail the QTE, does his arm just get ripped off? Hearing noises. Oh, it's the bugs. Bugs are back. Get off me! I don't like it. Is that every door? Yep. Don't laugh at me. Ah, damn it. This one.
Josh. Hey. Look at me, pal. Here.
I want Robbie.
This is yours, you remember? Where are you going?
Josh! Josh, come back! Where are you going? Josh!
I mean, that's just the correct response when some guy tries to hand you a blood-covered toy. Alright, RIP that door. Not doing so hot. Did I miss a door? Behind me? Nope, just hearing noises. Oh, I think I hear a faint sound of water lapping on the shore. The source seems to be coming from just beyond this door, but that's impossible. This is a hospital. You just have a TV, buddy. We can make sounds artificially in the modern world. The modern world of 15 years ago. I can't get through right now. Did I miss a door? No? There... Oh, there... Yeah. I can't get through it right now. It's kind of a funny way of phrasing. Press the button to the elevator. Oh, it's jammed. How do I solve this? Something's coming. What?
Petri.
What? That was an extended, like, false start? I was just about to talk about the lack of, like, normalcy. Like, we never established a status quo for this character. We just were immediately in Silent Hill.
Hometown? You could say that.
Why would you say it? Like, what kind of answer is that?
Good luck, soldier. Thanks.
This is your hometown? Something like that.
Thanks for the ride.
I am extremely unsure whether that's the protagonist of Silent Hill 5 or not. Origins. I genuinely don't know. He looks a lot like him, right? He's dressed like him. Is that just their idea of what every trucker dresses like, or is it literally him? I need to go home. What? Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. We're not recovering from this. This game definitely is just... I'm just gonna be laughing at this game. That's just what this playthrough is. Let's just give in to that. Oh, so he has a bizarre false start nightmare that just is what Silent Hill is like, which is like a total misunderstanding of how the buildup is supposed to work in these games in general. But also it's just like, see, it feels like an insecure, like, see, we are making a real Silent Hill game. Look at all these familiar Silent Hill pieces of iconography. Here's a nurse, here's the rust, blah, blah, blah. But like, it's also completely bizarre that he would have a dream about what is presumably what's going to happen in the game with such detail. That's like kind of a bit of a spoiler for everybody, isn't it? But the reason why I just started laughing is that, like, yes, like, he just got dropped off by maybe the guy from Silent Hill 5, I don't know. And he's like, something like that, in response to whether or not this is hometown, which it's weird to just not say yes or no. What the fuck? But no, the reason I'm laughing is he gets out, and the moment we're here, look at him! He has his knife out! He has a knife out! He just got dropped off in his hometown, and he's like, huh, I'm ready. I need to go to my house now. Like, I don't know, man, show, like, a spooky thing happened in a cutscene, like he sees something in the shadows or he hears something and he's like, what is that? But like, it's like, as far as we know, there's no reason to think anything's wrong besides the fact that it's a Silent Hill game. But he's not supposed to be that aware it's a Silent Hill game. Like, I don't know. Maybe we'll get some context for why he's going home that makes this make some kind of absurd sense. But I'm like, dude, you're just going home. Or like, some, is your child at home? I don't know. It's weird you have a knife drawn. There's a lot of reasons why it's weird you have a knife drawn. He doesn't have a flashlight. But he still has the knife equipped, but he doesn't have a flashlight. Yeah, just the lack of buildup is just like, well, I guess that dream really spooked him. Get it though? It's called Silent Hill Homecoming because he's coming home. To fan favorite Shepherd's Glen.
What happened to this place?
Alex?
Judge Holloway. Hey.
I didn't know you were home. Does your mother know? She didn't say anything.
No, I haven't talked to her. Actually, I haven't really talked to anyone. I'm not planning on sticking around for long.
Oh. Well, I hope you get a chance to catch up with Elle. I'm sure she'd love to see you.
She's still here?
Of course. You know how it is. No one ever leaves this place.
Yeah, I guess. This town's so quiet. It's changed.
Yes. Not for the better, I'm afraid. You should go home. See your mother. Perhaps I'll see you later. You look well, by the way.
Thanks.
See you later, jump scare judge. She seems nice. And I like to think that I'm a pretty big, good judge of character. Why does this game look worse than Silent Hill 2? I take back my compliments from earlier. What the fuck were those characters? They're really unnerving to look at. Their teeth are distressing. Like, people say this looks like a PS2 game as an insult on a regular basis. This game does not look as good as the PS2 game. Granted, it's Silent Hill, which is a very impressive visually Silent Hill PS2 game, but like, what? They look worse than James and Maria. How is that? It's been so many years. Why would they look worse than James and Maria? I'm so confused. You have all this, you have only more technology to go on. Maybe I gotta go back and do a comparison, but I'm pretty sure I'm, like, basically right. He still has a knife out. What if he just, like, stabbed her during that interaction? The light looks here. Like, the lighting in this room looks nice. It's just like a nice visual. But the character models are an actual nightmare to look at. And like, this is a series where people's behavior and appearances are kind of uncanny and creepy on purpose. But in this case, it's not on purpose. Put your knife away. I get that I could. I'm just like, why does he default to having his knife out? Nope, you don't have a map of your house. This is your house, by the way? Bro. Are you an oil baron? The history of Shepherd's Glen is one of opportunity and enterprise. First settled nearly a century and a half ago, its founders came here as pilgrims, searching for a new home to practice their faith and ensure the prosperity of their four families. It soon flourished into a thriving small town. Shops and businesses sprung up on what is now Main Street. The turn of the century brought tourists, eager to explore the region's lakes and rivers. And with tourists came more business. In the 1950s, many of the original municipal buildings, such as the town hall and the library, were restored. The 1990s encouraged further investment, modernizing Shepherd's Glen as it headed into the new millennium. But throughout its successes, Shepherd's Glen has always managed to remain a close-knit community, maintaining the same ideals on which it was founded. One can only hope that the founding families would be proud if they saw the town as it is today. And the sun, then you, the, why is the, it's blood spattered. Okay, maybe you should have a knife if the town's like this. Mom and Judge Holloway talking in our house. The photograph was taken by an asshole. They just both photographs people when they don't want it, and also just frames it like, okay, I'll be honest, frames it like I would. It's like a keyhole. I always thought the symbol was odd. Dad always got angry if I played with this. Dude, you lived in the Spencer Mansion. This is very weird. This is Cornelius Fitch. I thought I was gonna say Cornelius Fudge for a second there. Another of Shepherd's Glen's four founders. I always forgot that Dr. Fitch is his direct descendant. Doc never really liked to talk about it, town history. I'm sure I know it's correct grammar or whatever, but it's just, it's a hell of a thing. It's like, it's like saying demons, souls, attorneys, general. It's a photo of Shepherd's Glen back when Main Street was still a dirt road. I guess you just know that contextually, because you can't see the road being dirt in that picture. It's a clock tower. Who's that guy? Is that your magician that you're descended from? Your magician family? I can't click on these ones. That's a... That one vlogger? I can't remember his name now. Shit. Wheezy Waiter. Well, that's a blast from the past. I say that when he's probably still around for all I know. One of Mayor Bartlett's ancestors was a town founder. Bartlett has been mayor since I was born, and no one ever ran against him. I guess family heritage counts for a lot here. This is Edith Holloway, one of the town's founders. My father hated the Holloways, but Margaret always treated me well. She and Elle even sent me letters when I left for the war. More letters than anyone else sent. Sometimes I wonder how things would have turned out if I were born into a different family. Yeah, I'm remembering the context of the narrative, right. He has dog tags, he's coming back from the war. So him having his gun out is him having a weapon out is weird because yeah, he's not like, I mean, maybe bad stuff happened back in the day here, but he's not returning to some place 20 years later with unfinished business because of how bad things got. It's like, he left for the war and now he's coming back from that war. Oops, that's the old one we saw. So it's just very goofy. Need a different weapon to break through these boards. Welcome to Metroidvania in your unoccupied house. This place is infinite! I mean, I would be creeped out if I had a house this big. Why is it this big? Ah, yes. The traditional save point. Father always got mad if I touched this. He wanted to make sure that if he got tired of me, I couldn't come back. Alright, that's dark. I needed to make a save point joke. These plants look healthy. If someone has time to water the plants, why don't they clean up the rest of the office? Yeah, this place is actually a nightmare. It's an unorganized collection of township journals and election records. Looks like the last 50 years of farmers' almanacs. Oops. Each one is perfectly sorted. Not a single year is missing. So only those ones, but not these. These are specifically unorganized. It cares way more about farmers. But what's the farmer's almanac again? I feel like it might not be directly related, entirely related to farming. But there's something else to it. I feel like I've heard of that before. Nope, nothing going on there. Just a bunch of fucked up newspapers. Maybe this place is just so moist that all the plants survive on their own. Hi. Don't mind me, I'm just coming in unannounced with a knife. You wouldn't have to be a nurse, would you, by trade?
Hey, Judge Holloway. Can I ask you a question?
Sure, Alex. What is it?
The town seems empty. All the stores are closed or boarded up. What's going on?
It's complicated, Alex. A lot of things have happened since you left. I really think you ought to just go home.
How's Elle doing? I haven't seen her in years.
Things haven't been that easy for Elle, Alex. But she's a strong girl. And I have faith that she'll come through okay.
Does she ever ask about me?
I thought you two were just friends, Alex.
We are. Were. I was just wondering.
Yes, Alex. She does. I think she's missed you a lot.
Alright, it's their house, my bad. I think I was distracted by their faces during that conversation. It's a collection of law encyclopedias and town government papers. There's also a collection of newspapers from the neighboring towns. That's a stack that will grow quickly. That makes it even more, feel even more like I'm just in her house with a knife. Like, even more inappropriately. Am I wrong, or was there only three portraits of town founders and one was missing? Okay, we've gone the full circle. Right, I'm in town hall. Just a bit of a tangent, I guess. Can anybody ever tell you not to run with a combat knife in the fog?
Home. Feels strange to be back here again.
Okay, this is more comprehensible. Granted, I was thrown a little bit by the fact- Oh my god. Hey buddy. Are you gonna know- Have you noticed this? How close can I get? I'm afraid to test it anymore. Hey bud. You clock on this? Or is this just like your friendly neighborhood gulch? Like this was just always here. him having childhood memories and stuff just kind of made it easy to slot in the idea that this was just his absurd home he lived in somehow. It looks like something was trying to claw its way into the garage. The door won't open with the garage door remote. Duck Hunter. I don't want to.
Hello? Hello?
Huh, that's strange.
Hello, everybody. I'm guessing I'm the kid. Nope. Dad, Mom, and Josh. I don't remember this one. Must have been gone when they put it up. They're getting new photos without you. They're immediately done with you being in the family. This is my mom's favorite French poetry book. She loves poetry, and this is her favorite one from the French specifically. I have a numbered list in my head. These are Dad's books. He always got worked up if I touched any of his stuff. Sounds like he just gets worked up if you touched anything. Ever. This couch is really worn out. Me and Josh used to hide our comic books in the cushions. Mom always said they were a waste of time. She didn't understand. Ugh. I think these were my grandfather's candle holders. Mom always insisted on lighting them when people came over for big dinners. Hello, interesting lighting chair. Conspicuous. It's so well lit from this side, even though this is the side casting the shadow. Curious. Double doors in the middle of the house. I just look like a psycho running through their house with a knife. The image just keeps coming back to me. There was some kind of fucked up blood there, so things are getting weird a bit. But so far he hasn't acknowledged anything, so it just feels strange. It's a little picture of Mom and Josh. It was taken years ago. I guess he likes to remember she likes to remember him as a baby. I remember Mom sitting here, cradling Joshua as a baby. Mom and Dad's bed. Josh and I got caught jumping on it once. Of course, I got punished while Josh was totally let off the hook. What is it? Is Josh the final boss of this game or something? You got a grudge. He was always let off the hook, and everyone's got photos with Josh. What about Josh? Oh, we jumped on the bed, but what about Josh? Closet's creeping me out. It's a letter from Mom to Dad. She never sent me letters when I was in boot camp. Maybe you shouldn't have gone home, man. Besides the part where it's Silent Hill, probably. Adam, I know that you will soon return to me, but I miss you dearly, and writing to you always calms my nerves. Everything here is the same, but with you gone, the house is so empty. The letter ends there. I guess you never finished it. Well, she cared about your dad. Closet's empty. Where are the clothes? Are they in the suitcase downstairs? Did they take off? Old cassette. The label's been ripped off. I wonder what's on it. Look at these working mirrors. Granted, Silent Hill's known for having working mirrors and then doing some shit with them sometimes. It's always a little noteworthy whenever a mirror even kind of works. I used to hate taking baths when I was a kid. It was always a struggle to get me in the tub. He's extremely nostalgic, which makes sense. He's coming home.
Cool. Some of the pictures are even gone. Oh, thank God. Oh. Well, progress. I'm guessing it doesn't have- oh, no, we're good. Ah, why would you do that?
God, what's your problem?
I had a bad dream. Never mind. It's nothing.
Kinda looks like an inhaler.
Take it. If you get scared again, just turn it on. Okay?
Thanks, Alex.
Sure.
A thing to keep in your bed? Looks like my parents sold all my toys. It's not a dresser. Nothing useful. Big cartoon bazooka. So yeah, going from the beginning, it felt implied that it was like a father-son situation, but now we have context that, like, that's Josh. So, like, that's his brother. So he's got a younger brother, and since he was away for years, he remembers his younger brother as the age he was when he left. It's a photo of Dad and Josh fishing at the lake. Why am I never in any of these pictures? Because they hate you. You shouldn't have come home. It wasn't worth it. These guys suck. This bookshelf's seen better days, but there's something special about it. What? What? Normal. Normal.